Your decision to assault was precise, calculated, manipulative, devious, despicable. I don't have to add words because your survivors have said all of that. I don't want to repeat it. You can't give them back their innocence, their youth. You can't give a father back his life or one of your victims her life when she took it. You can't return the daughter to the mother, the father to the daughter. You played on everyone's vulnerability. I'm not vulnerable. Not to you, not to other criminals at that podium. I swore to uphold the Constitution and the law, and I am well trained. I know exactly what to do. And at this time, I'm going to do it. And I want you to know, as much as it was my honor and privilege to hear the sister survivors, it is my honor and privilege to sentence you. Because, sir, you do not deserve to walk outside of a prison ever again. You have done nothing to control those urges, and anywhere you walk, destruction will occur to those most vulnerable. Now, I am honoring the agreement. I'm also honoring what's been requested of me. And I want you to know, I'm not good at math. I have a cheat sheet. I'm only a lawyer. I know that you have a lot of education in physics and math, but I have a cheat sheet. It is my privilege on counts 1, 2, 5, 8, 10, and 18 and 24. To sentence you to 40 years, and when I look at my cheat sheet, 40 years, just so you know and you can count it off your calendar, is 480 months. The tail end, because I need to send a message to the parole board in the event somehow God is gracious, and I know He is. And you survived the 60 years in federal court first, and then you start on my 40 years? You've gone off the page here as to what I'm doing. My page only goes to 100 years. Sir, I'm giving you 175 years, which is 2,100 months. I just signed your death warrant. I need everyone to be quiet. I still have contempt powers. I told you I'm not nice. I find that you don't get it, that you're a danger. You remain a danger. I am a judge who believes in life and rehabilitation when rehabilitation is possible. I have many defendants come back here and show me the great things they've done in their lives after probation, after parole. I don't find that's possible with you. I won't make a statement until after the appeal period. And again, if there's any survivor then who, at that point, if somebody wants to talk to me, I'm sure you'll be moved on to another story. But if you're not, please give your names to the victim's advocate so that I can contact you, because Please, media, do not contact me on this story without a survivor. It's their story. I thank everybody in this case. Sir, I hope somewhere you have heard everybody's words, and it really does resonate with you. Anything else for the record?
Nothing but half.
All right. So the media is asked to stay here with all those lovely people who may want to speak with you. Thank you. That's all for the record.
All right.
I'm John King in Washington. Welcome to our viewers in the United States and around the world. You have been watching a powerful sentencing hearing in Lansing, Michigan. Listening in the end there, Judge Rosemarie Aquilina, who sentenced the former USA Gymnastics Dr. Larry Nassar to up to 175 years. Quote, "I just signed your death warrant," the judge said, that 50-year-old sexually abused girls under the guise of performing medical treatment. Just a powerful hearing. You see the prosecutor there hugging members of her team, hugging some of the survivors in the courtroom as well. The judge spoke poignantly. The prosecutor spoke poignantly. The defendant spoke very briefly, telling his victims and the survivors that there's no way that he could apologize, prying the right words for the pain, the trauma, and the emotional destruction that he called. Let's bring CNN legal analyst Paul Callen into the conversation. Paul, earlier in my career, I was in a lot of courtrooms. This was a wow. This was poignant from the beginning, powerful presentation by the prosecutor saying this must stop. The victims must be believed. This man must never set foot outside of a prison again. The defense attorney saying they've received death threats for handling this case. Nassar's statement, which I would say fall woefully short of a direct apology, saying he couldn't find the words for that. And then the wrap-up from the judge was stunning, powerful, and poignant.
John, it was a powerful, powerful scene. As a former prosecutor, I've witnessed many sentencings in many cases, murder cases, sex abuse cases, but very few as powerful as this. And I've never really seen a sentence as long as this being imposed, in a plea of guilty situation as we have here. The judge said that he's going to serve as much as 175 years in prison when her sentence is combined with the sentence of the federal court. Remember, he's doing 60 years on a child pornography case that he pled guilty to in federal court. But it was a powerful, eloquent statement by this judge.